Welcome back, students. Yesterday I gave some of the MCQs to find out the answers. So I am repeating them once again along with their answers. Question 1. The squirrel's tail is? Answer is curved. Second, its overcoat is its? Answer is fur. Third, the squirrel sits on its hind legs to? Answer is eat. Next, the squirrel loves to eat, and the answer is nuts. Last one, the word opposite in meaning to like is? Answer is dislike. So you must have noted all the answers in your notebook. Today I am going to discuss the chapter from your book An Alien Hand, which is titled as Bringing Up Curry. It's written by Dhan Gopal Mukherjee. It's about a baby elephant which is named as Curry. Bringing up means brought up, which is brought up by 9-year-old boy. A 5-month-old baby elephant Curry was given to author to take care of. The author was 9-year-old at that time. Curry lived in pavilion, which means a shed or a large tent. That pavilion had thatched roof. Thatched roof means a roof made of dried grass and rested on thick tree stumps. That pavilion, that tent was strongly built so that it could not fall in when Curry bumped against the poles. The author took Curry to the river every day for morning bath. First, he rubbed his body with clean sand. Curry lay in water for a long time. After that, the author rubbed water down his back and Curry squealed with joy. Curry likes to play in water a lot. Squeal means to make noise. Then author used to take Curry to jungle and there he left him on its edge. After that, he went into the jungle to get soft, tender leaves and branches for Curry. It was their almost daily routine. As the author used to take care of Curry, they both, because both of them were very good friends. Curry did not eat too much, but he needed about 40 pounds of twigs a day to chew and play with. So, the author sharpened the hatchets for half an hour. Hatchets means an axe. And then carefully cut the most tender and delicate twigs, because an elephant would not like to eat mutilated leaves. One day, when the author was busy in gathering leaves and branches for Curry, he heard Curry's calling. And the sound was almost like a baby rather than an elephant. The author thought that someone was hurting him. So he came down quickly from the tree. And very fast, he ran to the edge of the forest where he had left him. But the Curry was not there. He looked over but could not find him. Finally, the author went near the edge of the forest. And suddenly, he saw a black something struggling above its surface. When it rose high, he was able to see that it was the trunk of elephant. The author thought that the Curry was drowning. But he was helpless because he could not jump into the water and save, as the elephant was bulky, heavy for him to be lifted up. But again, he saw his back rise above the water and he was struggling to be up to the shore. Still trumpeting, the Curry pushed him into the water and fell into the stream. What the author saw, that there was a boy lying flat on the bottom of the water. He had not altogether touched bottom, but was something afloat. When the author came to the surface of water and took breath, there Curry was standing, his feet planted in the sandbank and his trunk stretched out like a hand waiting for author. The author dived down again and pulled the body of the drowning boy anyhow to the surface. but as he was not a good swimmer, he could not swim ashore because the slow current was already dragging him down. They tried very hard, and after a long struggle, the author and Kari became successful in saving the life of the child. So it was a great work which was done by Kari. Kari was just like a baby who need to be trained to be good. So the author used to teach him, and whenever he was naughty, he was up to more mischievous than ever if he was not told or scolded by the author. One day somebody gave Kari some bananas. As a result, he developed a great love for ripe bananas. This love dragged him to the field of theft. Kari started stealing bananas from his master's dining room. The author's parent, first they blamed the servant and then the author for this recurring incident. But soon the real thief was caught. How he was caught up? Listen. One day when the author was sitting in dining room planning to take some fruits without his parents' permission, he saw a long black thing coming in the room through window. It took away all the bananas and disappeared. The author mistook it a snake and rushed out of the house with fear. To overcome this fear, the author rushed to the pavilion and was very surprised to see that Kari was eating the bananas. So the real thief was caught. An elephant accepts punishment for having done wrong, but without reason he cannot tolerate. If you punish him without any reason, then he will remember it and pay you back in your own coin. An elephant must be taught when to sit down, when to walk, when to go fast, when to be slow. And if you teach him these things, you have to teach him like a child. If you say dhat and pull him by the ear, he will learn to sit down. Similarly, if you say mali and pull his trunk forward, he will gradually learn that it's a signal to walk. So Kari learned mali after 3 lessons, but it took him 3 weeks to learn dhat because he was no good at sitting down. And we know that while an elephant should be taught to sit down, because as he grow taller and taller than us, then who take care of them? So that when he is 2 or 3 years old, you can only reach his back with a ladder. Therefore, it's better to teach him to sit down by saying dhat, so that you can climb upon his back, because it's not easy to carry ladder all the time. Okay. The most difficult thing to teach an elephant is a master call, but it is very important task and takes 5 years to learn it properly. What is master call? It's a strange hissing and howling sound, as if a snake and tiger was fighting each other, and you might have heard. So you have to make such noise in his. With a master call, he can save his master from dangerous animals and can make way in dense dark forest within very. If you are lost in wood, the only thing you have to do is to give him the master call. What the elephant will do, he will pull down the trees with his trunk, and this will frighten all the animals away. Soon he will make a road right through the jungle straight to your house, and you can move up quickly. So it's really very important to teach him the master call. It might be clear to you that how the Kari was brought up by the author with love and care, and how he taught him different important lesson, and what was the characteristic and nature of the baby elephant. There are certain word meanings that I will tell you now, and you note down in your notebook in the form of homework. See the first one, pavilion. It means shade or large tent. Second, thatched roof. That means roof made of dried grass. Third, ebony, which means a hard, heavy, black wood. Squill means to make loud noise. Twig, small, thin branches.
Tender means soft or easy to cut.
Hatchet, which means a tool for cutting wood, or a small axe. And the last one, ponderous, which means heavy. So thank you very much for watching the videos. Keep it up.